As you begin to build more complex workflows with n8n, there may well be a time when you need to use something called a Node.js module inside of a code node in n8n. And you will recognize these inside of the function that you have been asked to put into the code node, often referenced here by the use of the term require. So I've created here just a very simple test function. And you can see here at the top that it says it requires crypto and requires express. These are both Node.js modules. Now, n8n has some of these modules already installed, but they're just not activated for use. Some of them are not available at all, but can be used, but they will need to be installed. In the description below, I've added a link to an article where I've provided a full list of all of the built-in modules that are available. So if your module is in that list, you can follow the built-in instructions. If it's not, then you will need to install it and activate it in order for you to use it inside of your workflow. You can tell that neither of these are the case when it comes to running the test in your workflow. So I'm going to run this test now. And you will see that it spits an error where it says it cannot find module crypto on line one. This means that crypto isn't available to use. Now, I know that crypto is a built-in module because it's in the list that I provided. What this does mean that it's available to use, but it's just not yet activated. And I'm going to share with you how to activate and use the built-in modules, and also how to install and use the external modules if your module isn't in that list. So let's deal with the crypto one first of all, which is a built-in module. So I'm going to drag in my terminal window because I need it for this. And again, in the article in the description below, you will find all of these commands as copy and paste options to make this just a little bit easier for you. The first thing that I need to do then here is to make a change to my docker-compose.yml folder. If you followed our guide on how to install n8n using Docker, then all of these commands will be totally applicable to you. If you didn't install n8n using Docker, I will share a video with you on how to install these in different installations. But I will do that at a later date. If you did install this using Docker, but you didn't follow our guide, then you might need to change the paths that are in these commands. So you will need to find where your docker-compose.yml folder is and change the path to those. I know in my guide that my Docker Compose file is inside of my n8n-docker-caddy folder, inside of my home directory. So I'm going to paste in this command cd space forward slash home forward slash n8n hyphen docker hyphen caddy to take me to that directory. And then I'm going to use nano as a text editor to create the changes that I need to make. So I'm going to paste in nano space docker hyphen compose dot yml. This will bring up my existing Docker Compose YML folder. And what I need to do then in order to use this crypto module or any of the built-in modules is to add in one additional line to the Docker Compose file. And it's going to go under, or inside of, sorry, the environment section. So I need to add in something here. So I'm going to use my arrow keys to scroll down to the last option that is in the environment section. And I'm going to press enter. Then I'm going to use my space bar to move this along just to line it up with the option above. And I'm going to paste in this variable, which is called node function allow built-in, and you can see here it's got equal crypto. And if I wanted to use crypto and some of the other built-in modules, I just need to create a comma separated list of the modules that I want to use. If I wanted to make them all available, I can just put a star here and that will literally activate them all. It's best practice though to only activate the ones that you need. So I'm going to take that back out and I'm going to change this back to crypto. And for now, this is all I need to do. So I'm going to control X to close this down, yes to save the modified buffer, and then enter to save the file. And once that's done, I just need to bring Docker down. So I'm going to use my Docker compose down command. And then I just need to bring it back up again by using the Docker compose up hyphen D command. And I'm just going to wait now a couple of seconds for all of that to happen. And when I go back to my workflow, we should find that the crypto issue has now been dealt with. So I'm just going to move my terminal window out of the way for a second so we can go back to my workflow. And it should have now brought itself back up again. So I'm going to test the step. And we can now see that the error has changed to cannot find module express in line 2, suggesting that the crypto module is now activated and available to use. So in this example, express is a node.js module, but it isn't one of the built-in ones. So what I now need to do with this one is to install and activate this in order to use it. And the process to do this is slightly more complex, but it isn't that complex in that it's just simple copying and pasting commands again. So to do this, I'm gonna bring back my terminal window so we can see what we need to do here. Now to make this work, I need to use something called a custom image in order to build n8n. If you have lots of workflows in your n8n instance already, please don't worry, this is not going to delete them. It's just going to change the way that the container that n8n runs in is built. We need to make this work then to create something called a Docker file. And this Docker file must go in the directory where your docker-compose.yml file lives. Again, if you didn't follow our guide, you will need to find that path. But if you did follow our guide, you can just use these copy and paste instructions. Now, I'm already in the directory where my Docker Compose file is, based on the last action that I took. And what I need to do now is to create something called a Docker file. So I'm going to use nano as a text editor to do this. So I'm going to paste in the command nano space Docker file. And if you aren't using copy and paste instructions, it's important that Docker file has a capital D. And I'm going to press enter on my keyboard. And because I don't have a Docker file already, it will create a blank screen like this. If you already have a Docker file inside of your instance, you will just need to add the run part that you will see in the bit that I'm going to add in just here. So the contents then of my Docker file, I'm going to paste in from my guide, look like this. So it's from n8n.io/n8n:latest/user/root. Run npm space install space hyphen g space express. And express is the module that I am looking to install. Similar to before, I can install lots of these if I wanted to. And the way I do that then is to create a list here. So I'm going to have express. And then it's space separated. So in this case, I would type the name of module 2 and the space of module 3. And I would just keep creating this list for all of the modules that I want to install. In my case here, it's just express that I want. So I'm just going to leave that as it is. Control and X. yes to save the modified buffer, and enter to save the file. Now I need to make a change again to my Docker Compose file. So I'm going to copy back over the command for the text editor, edit this, so nano space docker hyphen compose.yml. You can see here that this hasn't changed from the last time around. Now, if you're not using the built-in modules, then you don't need that built-in option that we just added, but I need crypto for my example. But I also now need to add in Express. But also, in order to make the custom image work, I need to change something else. So I need to scroll down to the n8n section here, where it's got image. And I need to delete all of this out. And I'm going to change this to build colon space full stop. Once I have that, I then need to add an additional thing to the environment section. So I'm going to scroll back down to here. Again, if you're not using built-in modules, then you can just pop this under the time zone option. But I'm going to leave this in because I need crypto. It's going to move to the end of this. I'm going to press enter to create a new line. Move this along to underneath and then paste in node underscore function underscore allow underscore external equal express. Now, if you were going to use multiple modules, again, similar to the built-in one above, we could use a comma separated list here of all of the other ones that I would like to use. So module 2, comma module 3. Or I could use again the asterisk sign. And what this will do is allow all external modules. It will only allow the ones that you've installed via your Docker file, remember. It is, again, best practice, though, to only activate the ones that you need. So I'm going to delete this back out and change this again to Express. And once I'm happy with that, Control and X to close the file down. Yes to save the modified buffer. And then Enter to close the file. My next stage now then is to bring Docker down. And a slight different variation now is that I need to now build my custom image. And to do that, I use Docker Compose Build. I'm going to press Enter, and I'm going to allow that to run. Now, that'll take just a few seconds. Once you get to the end of this and you can see all of that happen, yours will probably take a bit longer if this is the first time that you've done this. Once you get to the end of that, then we're going to bring Docker back up again by using Docker Compose Up -D. And we'll bring that back up until we get the created, started, started option. Now I'm going to give that a few seconds again. I'm going to move the command window out of the way so we can get back to my workflow. And I'm now going to test my step again. And now you can see I've got a green tick for the outputs. My output is whatever the output was supposed to be. And that simply means that the Express module is now installed and it's working. Now, an important note. If you have installed external modules, even if it's a combination of both internal and external, in order to update n8n when an update is available, you will need to use the Docker Compose down, Docker Compose build, and Docker Compose up -D command in order to update n8n. If you've seen our video on how to update n8n inside of Docker, that guide is now no longer applicable to you if you've used external modules. If you have only used internal or built-in modules, then that guide still applies. This is where you use Docker Compose pull, Docker Compose down, Docker Compose up, -d. But again, if you've installed external modules, you will need to use Docker Compose down, Docker Compose build, and Docker Compose up, -d in order to update n8n. I hope you found this short video useful. Please don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel, and I look forward to seeing you in another video real soon. Thanks for now.